So if you look at a data center globally, they use about 1.5% of the world's electricity. And over the next 5 years, that number is going to at least double, possibly even triple. And that's where the ULH, ultra-low harmonic drive, comes into play.
Before we get into that, can you just give me an idea of what a drive is in its most basic sense?
Sure. A drive is all about controlling the speed of a motor. So it doesn't matter if it's a pump or a fan, especially when you look at HVAC applications, they so rarely run at full speed. So when you don't need that full flow, that full pressure, you can slow the speed of that fan or pump down. And that's where the drive, what the drive does.
HVAC, you mentioned there, that's heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, I think.
Correct. HVAC, also known as HVAC, heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. We don't realize that we walk into a building and we just expect it to be warm or cool based on the season. You have no idea how many drives are actually in that building. You walk into the grocery store and the doors slide open and you get hit with the nice cool air. Well, that's HVAC, and those are our drives behind the scenes making that happen.
So in the context of these ultra-low harmonic drives, what are harmonics when we're talking about drives exactly, and why do we want them to be especially low?
It's great to use drives, but one of the negatives to a drive is how it consumes energy from the grid. It doesn't draw current linearly, evenly. What it does is it gulps current. So it takes some current, stops, takes some current, stops. And what that can do is it actually distorts the waveform. So a voltage waveform is that nice sinusoidal waveform that's coming out of the electrical outlet. Well, when you get too much gulping going on, it starts to distort that waveform. And then when the waveform is distorted, equipment doesn't run as nicely. It runs hotter. It runs less efficiently. It's really wasteful.
So the ultra-low harmonic drive is a way to keep those harmonics down then?
Correct. With the ultra-low harmonic drive, it doesn't gulp the current. What it ends up doing is it draws it smoothly. It doesn't create a meaningful amount of harmonics or distortion in the first place.
How new a technology is this, these ULH drives? Is this something that's fairly recent? Or
It's about 20 years old. So it initially came out for industrial applications, for regenerative applications. And then we looked at it and said, you know what? A side effect of it, or bonus of this drive, is it has a very low harmonic footprint. So we started looking at it for applications outside the industrial world, and it's been a really good fit for HVAC applications.
I was going to ask what kind of customers we're mainly talking about here. Like what industrial sectors are the most excited about this kind of technology?
Anybody who cares about their power quality, especially anybody who has backup generators. So your hospitals, your data centers, your laboratories are all folks who are very interested in low harmonic solutions.
Just talk to me about data centers a bit, because that's something we've been paying quite a lot of attention to recently. What's unique about their demands, and how well does this kind of drive fit their requirements, do you think?
So if you look at a data center globally, they use about 1.5% of the world's electricity. In the U.S., where I'm at, that's closer to about 4.4% today. And over the next 5 years, that number is going to at least double, possibly even triple, based on AI chips and the GPUs, the CPUs, and the energy consumption and the cooling needs of those chips. So we're going to see more data centers being built. And then as a result, the energy consumptions are going to be going up a lot because of the technology involved. So they're truly really trying to figure out, how do I get more with less? So they've got electrical infrastructure challenges. We're already stretching the grid as it stands today. So how can they get more with less out of their electrical infrastructure? And that's where the ULH, ultra-low harmonic drive, comes into play.
I mean, it's a fascinating story, how the growth of AI is driving such a huge global energy demand. And that's raising challenges across all kinds of sectors. So, I mean, how important do you think drives are in the combating of that, or addressing that issue?
It's very important. I mentioned briefly earlier that drives are important for energy savings. You can slow things down and save energy. So based on the loading changes over the course of the day, the drives can make systems run more efficiently. But then there's another step further. The ultra-low harmonic drive, because it draws current more effectively or more linearly, it allows the electrical infrastructure to be more effective with its power. So you can actually stretch and get more out of your system by using a ULH drive compared to a standard drive. So they're already using drives in data centers. Now it's taken that next step further. How do I get more out of my drives? And the answer is by going to ULH drives.
You talked there about the growth of AI, how many things that's driving. Obviously, you see quite a bright future for this technology then as we move forward.
Oh, definitely. And what's really interesting is seeing how everything is advancing right now in data centers. I guess when I really look at the future, it's all going to be about redundancy, though, having N plus one systems. If one pump goes down, you need to make sure you have additional pumps to keep the system operating. So in the past, you could lose airflow, for example, sometimes for up to 60 seconds and be able to recover your data center. Now, if this drive goes down and has nuisance faults and things like that on a pumping system, on a water-cooled system, seconds can cause a problem, where in the past you could have up to a minute. So when I look at the future of drives and I look at the future of data centers, it's really going to be able to continue that uptime, that reliability. You cannot have systems go down, or it's going to be very significant equipment damage.
Super interesting. It's a technology we're going to be keeping a close eye on over the years. Tim, thanks very much for your time today.
Sure. Thank you for having me.